Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me today is Dr. Carol Routledge, Chief Medical and Scientific Officer at Small Pharma. Carol, it's good to see you. How are you today?
I'm really good. Nice to see you too. How are you?
I am good. Thanks for asking. Carol, today we were talking about some very exciting phase one, phase 2A combination results from your clinical trial assessing DMT. So tell us a bit about what you found here.
So we are in the middle of our phase one, phase 2A study. We've just completed the phase one component, which was the first component. And that part of the study was really done to understand the safety and tolerability of different doses of DMT with therapy in psychedelic naive subjects. And psychedelic naive, because we think a lot of patients in the second part of the study are going to be psychedelic naive. And so it was very important that we understand the tolerability in that population of subjects or in those subjects. So essentially what we have found, and we looked at escalating doses of DMT with therapy, so that's increasing doses, is that first of all, DMT is very safe and well tolerated, and very well tolerated even at doses that elicit a breakthrough psychedelic experience. So we took the doses up to doses that did produce a psychedelic experience in all individuals that took it. And even at those doses, it's safe and well tolerated. And so on that basis, we've been able to select a dose that we can move directly into the phase 2A proof of concept component of this combined study. So we don't need to go back to the MHRA, we don't need to go back to regulators, but we can roll and have rolled straight into the phase 2A component of this study.
And just remind us what you're looking to treat here, major depressive disorder, and why you think DMT would be effective there.
So yes, we're looking to treat patients with major depressive disorder. It's still a real unmet medical need. There are treatments, but many of those patients go underserved by the treatments that are available. And the reason we think DMT with therapy should treat these patients is really based on a lot of the academic research data in humans demonstrating the mechanism of action. So depression is an ingrained condition. So basically, subjects have this cycling ruminative negative thoughts that it's really hard to break out of. And based on that academic research data, it seems that psychedelics, and DMT being one of them, modulate these ingrained patterns. And so they kind of open or reset the mind so that therapy is much more effective. And that's why it's called psychedelic-assisted therapy. You basically open the brain to therapy so that the therapy is much more effective.
And you've now already begun the second phase of the study. So tell us about the structure of that. What does that look like?
Yes, so we have started the second phase. The proof of concept study is a double-blind randomized placebo-controlled trial. It's in 42 patients. We're conducting it at two clinical sites, one in Liverpool and one in London. And there are two parts to that study. So the first part is the double-blind part, where we will compare the effectiveness of DMT with therapy versus placebo in all of those 42 patients, so 21 versus 21. Our primary endpoint is a depression scale, MADRS, which is the primary endpoint is 2 weeks after treatment. And then after they receive that treatment, then we will roll all the patients over into an open label part where they all receive active treatment. So they all receive DMT with therapy. And we're doing that for two reasons. So one, it provides the opportunity for all patients to have active therapy, which is an ethical approach, and also prevents a potential negative bias. But two, it also helps to inform us in our next trial, which will be the phase 2B trial, whether one dose versus two doses are effective, whether the two doses versus one dose is tolerable. So it gives us some information for the next trial as well. But really, it allows all patients to then have active treatment. We expect headline data from that study to be realized in the first half of next year. So hopefully we will understand whether DMT-assisted therapy is efficacious at the beginning of the first half of next year.
We will look forward to following your progress here. Such an interesting area. Carol, thank you so much.
Thank you very, very much. Thanks.